I'm Eddie Cannell.
And I'm Tom Cannell.
Welcome, everyone. This is the Mortgage Brothers Podcast. Another episode answering a question that we get a lot, especially during refinances. And it's something like this. Hey, my balance is $240,000. Why are you guys showing a higher number on the mortgage paperwork?
Right. Yeah, I have a, would you say 240?
240.
I have a $240,000 mortgage, and it's just like my bank account. Once it's there, it doesn't move. It just stays the same. So if I want to refinance my mortgage, I'm going to just get a loan for exactly that number, and it will all be okay. And we get that all the time. Why are these payoffs different? And why are they not lower? Why are they higher than I thought?
Right.
And can I just dispense a notion that we don't ever keep anything? I know a lot of, you know, borrowers, again, they don't know us. If they knew us, they'd actually love us, invite us over for dinner and stuff. but you know, we're not here in any way, shape, or form to ever take anything that is left over, that is overpaid, that is an overage, or that is under or overstated. There's so much regulation in this business that even if we kept a penny from, you know, the million loans that are done, we'd still have like 10,000 left over in a bank account, and like we'd be audited for it. So no pennies ever get left behind. These payoffs are a one-dimensional, formula-driven, what's your loan amount, what's your interest, and when are you paying it off? So I just think it's really important for people to know. I think at first glance, it seems simple. It's just a number that's static.
We're right. And people, for example, this is like very real life example. I mean, this is a payoff, right? And this borrower, if I were to ask, if he called me and asked me, he wanted to refinance, and I asked him what his balance was, he would look at his mortgage statement right here, right? This was generated July 3rd, 2020. He would say, I owe $126,917. And that's the loan. That's the new loan. So he thinks that if he refinances, that new loan should be $126,917. Now,
actually, we need to clean your glasses. It's $918.
Oh, there you go. What are dyslexia.
I think it's dirty lenses.
There you go.
Okay. All right. Keep going.
So what is a common mistake is, or shock is when we start, you know, when Tom and I, when our team tries to do a refinance for a borrower, we try to give them the heads up. Okay. So what's your balance? This borrower would have told me this right now, and I will have to let them know that is your mortgage balance. That is not going to be your mortgage payoff. Your payoff will be higher than that because mortgage interest is paid in arrears, and there is unpaid interest every day after you make that payment.
Right.
On the first of every month, every day, the payoff balance is increasing.
So I tell people, I call it the stair step scenario, is that when you make your payment on the first of every month, assuming you're on time, which you are because you're all wonderful, every day thereafter you wake up, your balance goes up. The interest is accruing every single day you wake up. And that's just simply how it works. There's an investor back in some other state or some other region who's counting the loan that he gave you, and that's his return on his money. And so every day, like your bank account, you end up receiving that interest. So just because you make your payment on June 1st doesn't mean that it stays flat for the entire month and then drops down again and then drops down again and drops down again. No, it actually escalates up before it drops down again, escalates up, and then it drops down again.
Right, right. And remember, you will always see on your mortgage statements, you should see the history of the last couple months or the last 30 days. So in this case, you'll see the payment applied. Okay. And that payment is obviously telling you, okay, the bank received it, your payment was received, and that principal up here, that $126,919 is the net outstanding balance after this payment was received. I wanted to actually go to the payoff, but did you want to have,
you know, I wanted anything? I just wanted to kind of look at this, and I wanted to kind of draw up a quick little scenario. Can we just go over a quick little scenario here?
Yeah.
Okay. So, and even for the most, you know, tenured people, you know, having mortgages for 30 years, sometimes they don't even know this. But when you look at this statement, it would have a statement date of July 3rd. Okay. This statement is really for the payment due in August. Okay. But it's based upon the July payment that was made on the 3rd. So as of the 3rd, it was all recalibrated, all recalculated, and boom, your actual payoff or principal balance would be 126,918.18. Okay. So July 4th, you know, happy 4th of July, July 5th, July 6th, every day thereafter, the interest clock, you know, train is ticking, ticking, ticking all the way up. You get to August 1st and you'd have a full month's worth of interest due at that time. So if you were sitting at your kitchen table August 1st, you could figure out my outstanding balance back in the beginning of July was 126,918. And Ed, how much do they have for interest for a full month?
Right there, $528.
$28.
So at the end of July, July 31st, the payoff is this number right here, the plus, basically, it's approximately this number right here.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So when you, so August 1st, you're sitting and you haven't made your payment yet, right? Because you typically make it on the 3rd of every month. So all of a sudden, August 1st, you're having coffee and you're like, wait a minute, what? To pay off my loan, I have to, you know, it's going to be $127,000, you know, $500. How can that be when it was, you know, lower at the beginning of the month? Well, it's just simply because of that stair-step approach. Now add into the equation that the refinance can sometimes, you know, it take, you know, 30, 40 days or so. And you start creeping into the next month. So I don't think we want to get into that scenario right now, but I did want to kind of take a quick look at this statement and go over that. And I think, Ed, those are some of the critical pieces.
Yes. So again, people just don't be surprised that there's the payoff. Why is your payoff higher? And that's what we're explaining. And I'm going to show you a payoff right now. This is something that a borrower does not use. You know, this is not something that a borrower sees. It's happening in the background, but we would order this through your bank, right? We would contact your mortgage bank and say, okay, we want to know what this borrower's payoff is.
And I'm just going to interject. So we're not coming up with this number. We're not sitting behind the screen trying to figure out how much money we think, you know, we need to pay off. No, we literally are going to your current bank saying, you know, what is it that you are requiring to have this loan totally paid off? And we simply receive a number.
That's right. This is not an arbitrary number. This is, like Tom said, coming right from your bank. And this borrower had an unpaid balance, like something similar that they would have seen on their mortgage statement, of $237,395. Now, in this case, if this borrower, let's say we were closing this borrower at the very end of July, or towards the end of July, right? So the payoff that we received, the bank said, okay, this is their balance, and this is the interest, $780.48 that has to be added on.
Right. So your balance as of July 1st was $237,395. But since almost 30 days, a full month, you know, have gone by, they simply add the 780 in there.
Yep. And that's why the borrower at the end will see, wow, my loan balance is $238,175. What? Right. I was looking at my statement and it said this number. What's right. going on?
So anyway, I do think
that's where it all comes from.
Okay, let's keep this up because I think this is good to go to step two. Step two is you're refinancing and we're actually going to be closing your loan, not at the end of the month, but we're going to creep into the next month at least 10 days. Okay, so late fees are not incurred on any mortgage payments, typically, not always, but typically until the mid-month. So some real savvy, very technical, you know, mortgagors, which are the borrowers, they'll say, you know what, I don't want to make my payment because I'm going to be refinancing. We say, no problem, you don't need to make your payment. So we'll take the 237,395 number, we'll add the full month of interest for July, or your existing lender will. And then the lender will say, well, when are you planning on closing this loan, Mortgage Brothers team? And we'll say, oh, it's going to be August 10th. We'll say, okay, let's add another 10 days of interest. Okay. On top of that, which, you know, a ballpark, you know, call it, you know, $250. So an extra $250 on top of the 780, on top of the original unpaid principal balance. Now throw in step three, which is they usually ask us for an extra couple days of interest. So that by the time they get their money, they're not short, you know, $6.18. So there's several different layers of interest that can get tacked onto your unpaid principal balance, which can make the balance just appear just way off. And it just is simply not. It's
right.
Again, mathematically, all extremely accurate because it has to be.
All right. I know that's kind of boring for a lot of people, but really it's a good exercise to go through, and you know, especially when you're refinancing.
Absolutely.
Paying off any loan. Mm-hmm. And the same thing, it's funny, mortgages apply, or mortgages, anything that amortizes, car loans, same way. Car loan, you know, anything that you have an amortized loan, this is the same way it's handled.
Right. Credit cards are a little bit different.
Right.
But anything that is amortized, yes, absolutely. So, and it's just a very simple concept. I don't know what you call the concept, but it's interest accumulation. And it's a way just to, you know, keep the investors happy that their money is, you know, that their money that they're lending to you is in fact making money on a daily basis. So,
all right. Well, I hope that helps everybody. Tom and I do this every week, right? Every week we try to get the answer to these questions. So be sure to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and ask us questions. You know, we want to be able to help you. And so I hope you all take care.
Yep. Give us a shout. You'll be actually talking to us. We've got team members, but you know, it's very important that we handle those calls personally. So you'll get us. So thanks a lot, folks.
All right. Take care, everyone. Hey guys, thanks for listening to the Mortgage Brothers Show. Please let us know if you have any questions you'd like us to answer on this podcast. You can email your questions to tom@azmortgagebrothers.com or yours truly at eddie@azmortgagebrothers.com. And be sure to ask us for a free quote on your next mortgage. Tom and I will personally work with you and help you through the whole process. Signature Home Loans LLC does not provide tax, legal, or accounting advice. This material has been prepared for informational purposes only. You should consult your own tax, legal, and accounting advisors before engaging in any transaction. Signature Home Loans, NMLS 1007154, NMLS number 210917, and 161-8695, Equal Housing Lender.